Hello, Ace. This is RetroTK2, and today we're looking at the Unity basic methods. We'll take a look at what makes a basic Unity script Ace, and also look at the start and update methods. We'll also go over some of the conditions that will be met with our C# series. So let's get started. Well, if you go down here and click on Unity Ace, it should open up as we've seen before. If you've watched my C# Bare Basics video, you should already have this project in the Unity dialog. If you don't, Ace, please feel free to download my channel files. The link is in the description, or you can simply go to my channel and click Channel Files. Right, let's get back to it, Ace. Open up the C# project that we've saved already with Unity. The project folder we'll be using today is the 2-bracket Unity Bare Basic Methods folder. There should be a scene file in this, Ace, so double click on that just to make sure that we're all on the correct scene. You won't see it in this recording, Ace, but there will be an after scene and our final script that we'll be constructing today. Let's create a standard C# script. So right click on the actual folder, go Create C# Script. If you've watched my previous C# Bare Basics folder, the actual script name didn't matter, but this time it does, Ace. We need to make sure it's a meaningful script name and it's not going to conflict with any of our other classes in our C# project. So yeah, I mean, a good sort of title for this one should be Tutorial 2. Why not? Double clicking on the tutorial script should open it. And it will be created using the default template Unity uses, Ace. Let's go through that just a little bit now. We've got usings at the top, which we don't necessarily need to worry too much about just yet, Ace. I'm going to get rid of them for now. But any time we want to use any of the Unity classes, we'll need to import the UnityEngine namespace. Again, Ace, don't worry too much about that. We're just going to go down through this as is at the minute. Now, these are called comments, Ace, but I don't really want to worry too much about them yet. I've got an entire video planned for them, so let's just get rid of them for the minute. If you haven't watched the C# Bare Basics video, Ace, I'd highly recommend watching it. Otherwise, this is going to seem a little bit confusing. Now, we haven't had the chance to go over access modifiers, Ace, although they were briefly touched upon in the C# Bare Basics video. And here at the minute, it doesn't necessarily matter that much either. The name of the class needs to be the same name as our actual script, so these two need to line up correctly. But we'll touch upon that a little bit later. Now, we haven't seen something like this before. This is inheritance, and we'll have a video dedicated to inheritance later on in the series, Ace. For now, we'll just say that by inheriting from the Monobehaviour class of Unities, we're able to attach this script to an actual game object. And really, that's about as far as it needs to go for the moment, Ace. If I didn't have this Monobehaviour on the actual class, we wouldn't be able to drag and drop it onto the script. Let me show you that now for a minute, Ace. If we go back into Unity, you'll be able to see that I can click on the main camera, click Tutorial and drag it down, and it will actually attach that script to our Monobehaviour class. If I remove that component and take away Monobehaviour, save it out and make sure it all recompiles correctly, you'll see that it also won't allow me to actually attach the script. Can't add script behaviour tutorial to, the script needs to derive from Monobehaviour. So it needs to inherit from Monobehaviour. We will completely go over this in a later tutorial, Ace. Just for the moment, be aware of that. Let's get into the main topic of this video, Ace. The Unity methods, or at least the basic ones, start and update. Now, if you watch my Logging to the Unity Console video, you'll already have been introduced to these methods, Ace. But let's revisit exactly what these methods do, because it is very, very important. Now, the start method is called only once per script, Ace. If we go through and define our basic debug log, say start, head back into Unity and attach the actual script to a game object and press play, it'll log it to the Unity console. Now, this isn't always true, Ace. If I disable this game object and press play, you'll see that the actual start method hasn't been called. This is because the actual game object has been disabled. If I enable it, it'll get called once. But if I keep re-enable it, it won't get called again. Now, this is an important trait of these Unity methods, Ace. Unity's using these methods in its own sort of magic way. It's using something called reflection, Ace, and that's out of the scope of even this C# series. We will touch upon reflection, and I will go back and revisit this topic in a lot more detail, but for now, it doesn't necessarily matter to get us all up and running. Just know that there is differences between the actual Unity methods. For everything that we'll be doing throughout this series, we will have the actual game object constantly enabled, so that it will fire only once whenever the actual thing starts. This has all been covered in the Logging to Console video, Ace, so be sure to check that out. Now, the update method works a bit differently. Start is only called once. Update is called once every single frame. So we go through and type out our basic debug log and just put in maybe update or something like that. You'll see that the update actually gets called constantly. And it'll continue to update like that is. Even if I take off collapse, it'll continue to spam this console with the update log. We won't really be using the update method in the videos to come is, but it's good to get in a good introduction to this. I mean, this method is pretty much the basis of Unity. At least at a beginner level, you're mostly putting your logic into the update method. But whenever it comes to the videos to come, this is really all we're going to be needing is. I will go through a lot more in depth about what this actual method call is, and especially since it's a static method call. We'll touch upon that in a later video is. The logging aspect of these tutorials is more just to show the effects of what we're actually doing. And this is the best way I can think of to do that. Now we've got that out of the way, yes, I want to show you what happens whenever the actual class doesn't line up with the actual script name. For this here, I'm going to change tutorial 2 to tutorial pop. Pop's always something I use for like a temporary variable or some sort of thing I'm just trying to iterate quickly. It's not exactly the greatest practice in the world to use, yes, but I always find it is kind of important. So now if we go through and wait for it, the actual reset, drag our actual script onto the thing, you'll see that we can add script component tutorial 2 because the script class cannot be found. Make sure that there are no compiler errors and that the file name and class name match. It's as simple as that is. We need to make sure that the actual scripts line up. Another thing about that is that you can have them be the both exact same name and drag and drop the actual script on, then come back and actually change the name of it. When you'll see that the associated script cannot be loaded, please fix any compiler errors and assign the valid script. And if we actually try to run the game, you see it does run, the actual game object is enabled, but there's no logs to the console at all. There is. Nothing is being used. And although it may seem that the actual tutorial 2 script has been attached to the game object, it's not constantly running it. It hasn't been added to the Unity calling methods and all that sort of fun stuff, yes. Make sure that the actual script name and the class name line up, yes. This is it, yes. This is really what we're going to be using whenever I'm trying to tell you about how to use C#. Starting out like this means that I've introduced you to a lot of concepts, yes, and haven't gone into any sort of detail on them. But now as we go through the actual series, you'll be able to see how all this can line up together. And we'll go through it in a lot more detail, yes. I hope you've enjoyed this haphazardy sort of way, yes. I haven't been recording with any sort of script at all, and really it's been a complete mess. And it will be the style that I'll be using from now on, yes. It's just going to be a lot quicker, I think, and it won't sound quite so monotone, and I think it'll help retain my personality doing it this way. And doing it this way in this sort of haphazard way means I don't have to write a script and the production time will actually be reduced, although the quality won't be exactly the same. Having said that though, as the series goes on, I guarantee you I will get better. I have to. I mean, this has been kind of terrible and haphazard, but so long as you learn the stuff is, it doesn't really matter. And that's it. Rate, comment, and subscribe, yes. I hope you've enjoyed this mess of an episode. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with anything you like, yes. Thank you for watching this, and I'll see you in the next video.